Hi, welcome to Gradient. I am Mr. Dell. Gradient is a channel that discusses interesting math problems, and you're watching the first video of this channel. Consider the following diagram. There are three circles. The green circle has radius 4, and the blue circle has radius 2. The horizontal line is tangent to all three circles, and the three circles touch each other. What is the radius of the red circle? That problem is challenged for student age 14 and 15. Can you solve it? Pause the video if you want to give it a try, or keep watching the video to learn how to solve this problem. We'll make the right triangle by connecting the center of the circle. First of all, connect the center point between circle of radius 4 to circle of radius r. Make right triangle with base x. The hypotenuse is 4 plus r. And the other side is 4 minus r. With the Pythagorean theorem, we get the equation x squared is equal to the quantity of 4 plus r squared minus the quantity of 4 minus r squared. Do a little bit algebra, we get x is equal to 4 times square root of r. Next, do the same with the circle of radius 2. Make right triangle with base y. The hypotenuse is 2 plus r. And the other side is 2 minus r. With the Pythagorean theorem, we get the equation y squared is equal to the quantity of 2 plus r squared minus the quantity of 2 minus r squared. Do a little bit of algebra, we get y is equal to 2 times square root of 2r. Do it one more time with two larger circles. The base side of the right triangle is x plus y. The hypotenuse is 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. And the other side is 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. With the Pythagorean theorem, we get the equation quantity of x plus y squared is equal to 6 squared minus 2 squared. Square root both side, we get x plus y is equal to 4 times square root of 2. Substitute x and y into the last equation, then simplify it. Factor the square root of r and divide it both side by 2 plus square root of 2. Simplify this equation again. We can multiply the numerator and denominator by 2 minus square root of 2. Then we square both sides, we get r is equal to 12 minus 8 times square root of 2, or approximated to 0.6863. And here's the answer. Did you get the right answer? Let's generalize this problem to get interesting relationship between the radii of the three circles. Do the same step as before with circles of arbitrary radii A, B, and C. Connect the center point of the circles of radius A to the circles of radius C. Make a right triangle with base x. The hypotenuse is the sum of the radii A plus C, and the other side is the difference of the radii A minus C. With the Pythagorean theorem, we get the equation x squared is equal to the quantity of a plus c squared minus the quantity of a minus c squared. Do a little bit of algebra, we get x is equal to 2 times square root of ac. Do the same with the circle of radius b. Make a right triangle with base y. The hypotenuse is the sum of radii b plus c, and the other side is the difference of the radii b minus c. With the Pythagorean theorem, we get the equation y squared is equal to the quantity of b plus c squared minus the quantity of b minus c squared. Do a little bit of algebra, we get y is equal to 2 times squared bc. Do it one more time with the larger circle. The base side of the right triangle is x plus y. The hypotenuse is the sum of the radii a plus b, and the other side is the difference of the radii a minus b. With the Pythagorean theorem, we get the equation quantity of x plus y squared is equal to the quantity of a plus b squared minus the quantity of a minus b squared. Do a little bit algebra, we get x plus y is equal to 2 times square root of ab. Substitute x and y into the last equation, then simplify it. Finally, multiply both sides by 1 over the square root of abc. We get an interesting relationship between the three radii of the circle in this case. 1 over the square root of a plus 1 over the square root of b is equal to 1 over the square root of c. Very interesting. We can solve this problem more easily through this formula. You can use this formula to solve the similar problem.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and share if you like it. And see you in the next video.